This is JSA TV, the newsroom for tech and telecom professionals, and JSA Radio, the voice for tech and telecom on iHeartRadio. I'm Jamie Scott-Okataya of JSA, here at the beautiful closing reception of TEX LA. Wrapping it up here with me is Mr. Ron Gruia. He's Emerging Director Telecoms. What's the title over at Frost?
Director of Emerging Telecoms.
I was close. Director of Emerging Telecoms over at Frost & Sullivan. Basically the go-to analyst for anything in our industry. So tell us, Ron, you were an amazing moderator of our last panel on cybersecurity and IoT. What were your key takeaways from it?
Oh, I think, first of all, thank you for the opportunity to be here. It was a great event, terrific venue, and I certainly learned a lot, not just from my session, from the other sessions that you're here. You put together a quality event with some of the key speakers in the industry. So I think in cybersecurity, there were quite a few interesting points. I think, one was the role of service providers that they have to play to secure the, I call it the home frontier, which is definitely one that's been very prone to hacks. I mean, there's a lot of unsecured sort of vulnerability points, when you think about, for instance, baby monitors and, a lot of the people, they don't take the measures. Like you could even set up a wireless router with a default configuration, which sometimes could be the MAC address. Like I know TP-Link, some of those routers, they use, very few users, they don't bother to change the default password and allows hackers to hack into them. So I think, certainly from the panel, that was one of the things that we learned today, that, the role of service providers, standardization efforts are underway, several organizations, and I think one of them that came across, which was interesting, the Metro Ethernet Forum, IEEE and others. And I think, the one thing we didn't get a chance to discuss because, we got, it was a great fireside chat, but I think, we didn't talk about the human element, but I think that's also important, like, when you talk about hacking and think of guys like Kevin Mitnick who are trying to always do some social engineering, etc. But I mean, I think it was a great panel and you certainly had a lot of good contributors.
Thank you, and you being, of course, one of them,
thank
so we
you.
Appreciate you
I'm
coming.
I'm excluding myself, yeah.
And tell us over at Frost & Sullivan, what is the latest and greatest? What are the trends you're seeing?
All right, so we're doing a lot of research these days, me personally, on 5G and also SDN and NFV, so software-defined networking and network functional virtualization. It's a tool, I guess, to enable carriers to not just virtualize, but also software-define their networks to achieve economies of scale, to dynamically scale their networks and be able to really not only derive OPEX savings, but also deploy things, faster, because I think, to David Walsh's point in a session earlier to ours, I think the time to market is a key thing.
Yeah.
So certainly that's going to be an enabler. So that's one of the things we're looking at. I think, we're also looking at value-added services. So all of the providers, it's an industry that's kind of changing itself quite a bit, rapidly commoditizing, but also very strategic to carriers. So, and we're also doing a lot of primary research. We have a custom research group that's doing quality work, getting feedback not just from consumers, but also service providers. So quite a lot of interesting research there.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. Yeah.
And certainly connected cars was a theme here. We had a co-located reception with Automobility, which I got to chat with you at.
Sure.
And smart machines coming on the rise.
Yeah.
What's it going to do to our bandwidth? Are we able to absorb all this consumption?
Yeah, well, I mean, obviously, I think we're trying to be leaders. I think our FCC chair has been pushing that to saying, let's try to be more proactive on 5G to be at the forefront, which is very good. I mean, Chairman Wheeler is doing the right thing there. I think service providers are also pushing the envelope. I think carriers certainly like Verizon and AT&T are, for the first time ever, they're conducting trials even before the spec is actually done, which is sort of unique for 5G. So I think, the key is going to be also looking at millimeter wave and new spectrum that's going to be licensed. And also how do we make effective use of that spectrum? How do we, do the densification of the network and use small cells, etc.? So that's all going to be very interesting to watch that unfold. Over the next, it's even happening now, but I think next year we're going to have Verizon do a fixed wireless, commercial trial. So, it's going to be exciting. But I think for wireless, it's going to be more like 2020. That's, Summer Olympics of Tokyo.
Wow. Yeah. Summer. Wow.
Yeah.
I'd like to say you are from Toronto.
That's right. That's right. I want to say I'm excited that you guys are coming to Canada, and I want to help you there, and look forward to having a similar event to this in Toronto or wherever else, whatever other venue you choose. Looking forward to that.
Thank you, Ron. Yes, we'll absolutely be leaning on you as we roll out JSA Canada. And thank you for joining us here today in LA. We will definitely see you also June 20th, 21st in New York City, Battery Park, Cipriani's Wall Street. And
another great venue.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. And hopefully in Toronto soon. So thanks again, Ron.
Sure. Look forward to it. Thank you.
And thank you, viewers, for tuning in to JSA TV.